I'm Dr. Stephen Greene from the Duke Clinical Research Institute. Current guidelines for heart failure give class 1 recommendations to the use of diuretics for the treatment of congestion and improvement of symptoms. Yet, there are no large-scale randomized trials showing which loop diuretic, if any, may best achieve these goals. Now, we presented at the American Heart Association meeting last year the primary results of the TRANSFORM-HF trial, which showed that a strategy of torsemide versus furosemide had no significant effect on clinical outcomes, including mortality or hospitalization. But at this HFA meeting from the ESC, we'll be presenting for the first time the pre-specified patient-reported secondary outcomes to better understand if a strategy of torsemide versus furosemide might improve quality of life and symptoms for patients with heart failure. So there is preclinical data to suggest that torsemide has potential advantages over furosemide. Things that get talked about a lot are increased bioavailability and more consistent diuretic effect. There's also some studies that suggest maybe antifibrotic or almost aldosterone antagonist-like effects with torsemide, yet we haven't had, until TRANSFORM, a large-scale trial designed to test differences in outcomes and actually patient-reported outcomes for those two loop diuretics. TRANSFORM-HF was a large-scale, pragmatic, randomized trial of patients hospitalized for heart failure in the United States. We enrolled 2,859 patients, and prior to hospital discharge, they were randomized 1-to-1 to a strategy of either torsemide or furosemide. They then were followed up post-discharge via routine clinical care with no study-specific in-person visits, and instead we had a centralized follow-up procedure where we used the National Death Index, as well as had the telephone call center from the Duke Clinical Research Institute, which we used to gather the patient-reported outcome data and other information. Patients were eligible for TRANSFORM regardless of ejection fraction. All patients did need a long-term plan for a loop diuretic. And importantly, the other thing to understand with the design of TRANSFORM was that it was an open label study. So while the treatment strategy of torsemide versus furosemide was randomized, the dosing actually was not, and it was up to clinician discretion, and they could titrate as they thought needed during the follow-up of the trial. At the ESC HFA meeting, we presented the effects on the two pre-specified patient-reported outcomes in TRANSFORM. That was the change in KCCQ clinical summary score and the PHQ-2 score, which is a screening tool for depression. Overall, when we compared a strategy of torsemide versus furosemide, we found no significant difference in the change from baseline in the KCCQ clinical summary score at 1 month, 6 month, or 12 month follow-up. And also similarly, we saw no significant difference between the likelihood of having a PHQ-2 score greater than 3 during follow-up between a strategy of torsemide or furosemide. The results for the KCCQ clinical summary score were consistent across several subgroups that we tested. And we also did a responder analysis to say, well, was there a differential odds of clinically meaningful improvement or deterioration in the KCCQ score during follow-up with torsemide versus furosemide, but saw no significant difference between the two loop diuretics. So based on these results from the TRANSFORM-HF trial and what we saw with no significant difference between torsemide and furosemide for symptoms or quality of life, for improving symptoms and quality of life in heart failure, which we all focus on a lot, focusing on which particular loop diuretic to use should not be a priority for spending in clinical time. Instead, our clinical time is better spent focusing on, one, ensuring optimal loop diuretic dosing rather than the particular agent, but also, and most importantly, timely optimization of guideline-directed medical therapy. Diuretic use in heart failure is really a black box where it gets a lot of emphasis, like I mentioned, the class 1 guidelines, but not a lot of specifics on how to best use these agents. So, you know, one unanswered question with loop diuretics is, well, what should they be paired with, if anything, in terms of like a second adjunctive diuretic? What is the optimal dosing? That is a ripe question for clinical research. And also, you know, in TRANSFORM, we randomized patients where there was relative equipoise between use of torsemide versus furosemide. But what about the patients that are maybe struggling on one loop diuretic? And in those situations, which again, were not eligible for TRANSFORM, would it make sense to switch them to a different strategy, a different agent, or what have you. So I think these types of questions are still very unanswered, and we have a lot of work to do with understanding how to best use diuretics for heart failure.